Amici sportivi, buonasera. Eccovi un po' per dimenticare la sfortunata prova della Juventus a Bruges e un po' per vedere dell'ottimo calcio l'altra semifinale della Coppa Campioni, quella che vede di fronte il Borussia di Mönchengladbach a sinistra in maglia bianca e gli inglesi del Liverpool alla vostra destra. Vedete ora l'azione dei tedeschi con l'ala destra Delai che è subito controllata dal terzino inglese Hughes. Ricorderete che Borussia e Liverpool furono le finaliste della passata stagione. A Roma vinsero gli inglesi per 3-1. La prima partita di questa semifinale è stata disputata a Düsseldorf e ha visto la vittoria del Borussia per 2-1. Squadra per passare all'Amburgo. E pochi giorni fa Keegan, intervistato a proposito di questa partita, si è espresso molto ottimisticamente in favore dei vecchi compagni. Ora è Sonnes alla manovra. In direzione di Highway, tiro di Kennedy e pronta parata di Clef. Kennedy è un mediano di spinta, uno dei più forti giocatori del Liverpool nazionale inglese. Rivediamo l'azione, ecco la conclusione di Kennedy da fuori area e la sicura parata di Clef, portiere del Borussia. Non è azzardato dire che questa tra Liverpool e Borussia è l'autentica finale di questa edizione della Coppa Campione. Indubbiamente si tratta di due squadre che da parecchi anni sono al vertice del calcio internazionale. Tra l'altro furono protagoniste della finale di Coppa UEFA nell'anno 72-73. Vinse il Liverpool all'andata per 3-0. Vinse il Borussia al ritorno per 2-0, ma la Coppa passò agli inglesi per la differenza reti. Vi ricordo che la partita di andata ha visto il successo del Borussia ora all'attacco per 2-1. In quella occasione segnò il terzino sinistro tedesco Hannes, pareggiò Johnson a 3 minuti dalla fine, ma a 1 minuto dal termine Bonhoff, con un'autentica punizione bolide, riuscì a far chiudere in vantaggio la propria squadra. Borussia all'attacco. Questi è Henkes. Traversone, intervento di Smith. Ed è Neil che fallisce il rinvio definitivo. La palla comunque giunge a Case che promuove il contropiede per il Liverpool. In direzione di Dalglish, ma interviene Hannes, uno dei più giovani, 21 anni. Hannes, vi ricordo, ha segnato il gol nella partita di andata ed ha una particolarità molto interessante, è cieco dall'occhio destro in seguito ad un incidente verificatosi da ragazzo. E ora Dalglish all'attacco, traversone in direzione di Kennedy, colpo di testa e rete. Siamo al 7° minuto e Roy Kennedy ha portato in vantaggio il Liverpool. 1-0 quindi, rivediamo l'azione molto bella. È stato un affondo di Dalglish, vedete in posizione di ala destra, preciso il suo traversone e Kennedy, specialista nei colpi di testa, non sbaglia da posizione favorevolissima. 1-0 per il Liverpool al 7° minuto del primo tempo nella seconda semifinale per la Coppa Campioni. A questo punto ovviamente la squadra inglese è qualificata per la finale ed è ancora l'ala destra Dalglish che rivedremo ai prossimi mondiali con la maglia nazionale scozzese che promuove questa iniziativa. Dalglish è un elemento molto importante, la punta vincente del Liverpool. E questa sera il suo contributo sarà particolarmente prezioso. Avete visto che da lui è nata l'azione che ha portato Kennedy in posizione gol e che consente quindi agli inglesi di iniziare alla grande questa partita difficilissima. Ancora Liverpool all'attacco. Intervento di Wittkamp, un giocatore molto esperto, è una della vecchia guardia del Borussia. Scambia con Völlers, La palla ritorna però agli inglesi, la muove Sonnes verso Neil. Ancora Kennedy in posizione offensiva verso Hughes. McDermott. Dalglish è fermato, ancora Kennedy dal limite, ma interviene Bonhoff e allontana, fornendo un pallone utile a Delay. Lungo il traversone non interviene Nielsen, che Udo Lattek, ecco un colpo di testa di Henkens. Nielsen, vi dicevo, è un centrocampista della formazione tedesca che questa sera Udo Lattek, l'allenatore del Borussia, ha schierato con la maglia numero 9, ma con evidenti compiti di copertura a centrocampo. A questo punto però la situazione è già parzialmente compromessa per i tedeschi e vedremo se il signor Lattek porterà delle varianti allo schema tattico del Borussia. Intanto avete visto McDermott fermato da Wittkamp in calcio d'angolo. In direzione di Smith, molto bello il suo colpo di testa e la pronta parata di Cliff. Udo Lattek, il tecnico del Borussia, ha già delle esperienze non proprio favorevoli qui a Liverpool, che risalgono ai tempi in cui egli guidava il Bayern di Monaco. Disputò due partite, il Bayern sull'Anfield Road, rimediò 1-0-0 la prima volta e fu seccamente sconfitto per 3-0. Manovra Nielsen per il Borussia. Nessun pericolo comunque per la porta di Clemens. Jimmy Case allontana in direzione di McDermott. Vedete com'è rapido il contropiede degli inglesi, ora affidato a Iway. Si è spostato in avanti anche Smith, quindi Dalglish evita un avversario. McDermott, la palla rimbalza sul volto di Hannes ed è appunto Nielsen che allontana. Liverpool ovviamente favorito in questa partita, i tifosi locali non danno mai agli avversari la speranza addirittura di poter emergere in questo stadio, che è uno dei più famosi del calcio inglese, perlomeno da quando il Liverpool è assurto a prima stella del calcio internazionale. Vedete un tentativo di reazione da parte del Borussia, che il gol di Kennedy ha messo in evidenti condizioni di inferiorità. Il primo piano è dedicato a Highway, centravanti irlandese in forza da diverse stagioni a Liverpool. Questi è Fox, Kulik. Traversone in direzione di Henkes, troppo lunga la palla e ancora Jimmy Case si incarica di impostare la manovra offensiva per i compagni, quindi Smith, Thompson, uno dei giocatori più in forma del Liverpool, Emily Hughes schierato con il numero 6 ma con evidenti funzioni di terzino sinistro. Avete visto un'entrata piuttosto dura di Bernie Vox ai danni di Highway. Vox è giocatore di grande esperienza, uno dei punti di forza della stessa nazionale germanica. In azione Dalglish, sul quale interviene prontamente Wittkamp mettendo in corner. Vox, lo ricordiamo, l'anno scorso montare la guardia a Kevin Keegan non fu un duello molto fortunato, per la verità, per il giocatore tedesco. Ricorderete che quella sera a Roma Keegan diede autentico spettacolo e guidò il Liverpool alla conquista della Coppa Europa. È Highway che batte l'angolo, respinta, colpo di testa di Kennedy, lo vedete sempre pronto soprattutto nel gioco alto, ma questa volta il tentativo del mediano inglese si spegne oltre la traversa. Uscito non molto tempestivamente Cliff, questa volta gli è andata bene. Vediamo un'iniziativa del Borussia che si conclude però in fallo laterale. La rimessa sarà operata da Nil. Vedete come è modificato il gioco dei tedeschi, non aggrediscono più i loro avversari nell'altra metà campo, preferiscono aspettarli nel proprio settore, e ciò sorprende anche perché è un po' contro il temperamento della squadra tedesca, che è sempre stata piuttosto battagliera. Attacco del Liverpool, tiro di Sones, rimedia Fox scambiando col proprio portiere Clef. Questo Sones, vedete quanto sia rilevante il contributo offensivo di Roy Kennedy, un elemento molto utile anche a Greenwood, il commissario tecnico inglese. È Bonhoff che rimette in gioco, ma evidentemente Palotai ha riscontrato una irregolarità e pertanto la rimessa passa agli inglesi. Bonhoff è un altro big del calcio internazionale, ha 26 anni, tra l'altro si dice che sia stato richiesto dopo che il MEC ha aperto le frontiere da parecchie società, e tra le altre si è fatta anche il nome della Juventus. Highway in azione, fermato da Fox in calcio d'angolo. Come potete rilevare da queste prime immagini, è il Liverpool che mantiene l'iniziativa ed è ora in azione Delai, che è subito fermato dalla coppia centrale Thompson-Smith. Sbagliato il passaggio di Case, ma rimedia McDermott. Highway, Fox. Non riesce a liberarsi il centravanti inglese, Hughes al tiro, deviazione di Delai e parata sicura di Cliff. Il primo piano è per Emilyn Hughes. Vi dicevo di Bonhoff, che è un giocatore di grande talento, è quello che ha segnato il gol vincente, ma ecco in azione Nielsen, pallonetto impreciso verso Clemens. Dicevo di Bonhoff, è quello che ha segnato il gol vincente nella partita di andata disputata a Düsseldorf a un minuto dalla fine. Si è trattato di un calcio di punizione violentissimo che ha addirittura fatto paura a Roy Clemens, il quale è stato poi accusato da, per esempio, è facile preda di Clemens. La respinta di Wittkamp. Da Sones in direzione di Case, traversone verso Highway, tiro di Kennedy. Ancora McDermott. Neil, che è uno specialista di questi cross in area. Hughes, Kennedy, Highway, Smith, messo a terra da Nielsen. Vedete con quanta difficoltà il Borussia tenti di arginare l'offensiva scontatissima dei giocatori inglesi. C'è questo calcio di punizione in favore del Liverpool per fallo commesso da Nielsen. Vedete Smith liberato da un preciso pallonetto di McDermott, e Clef è intervenuto molto bene. Rivediamo l'azione. McDermott, pallonetto molto prezioso per Smith che conclude bene, ma Clef è bene appostato e riesce a rimediare. È la seconda vera palla gol per il Liverpool. Fox ha mantenuto in campo una palla per Delay che non ha saputo approfittarne, anche perché è stato calpestato da Hughes, un difensore piuttosto rude contro il quale il giovane Delay si troverà certamente a mal partito. Questo è Kulik verso Wima, fallo laterale in favore del Liverpool. Smith, ancora Kennedy, pronto intervento di Wittkamp. Sonnes, ancora Smith che è il libero, scambia con Thompson, liberato dalla marcatura di Nielsen perché, come vi dicevo, gioca arretrato. McDermott, hanno quasi sempre la meglio i giocatori inglesi sulle palle alte. Ecco Nielsen in azione difensiva e vedete che lo sbarramento preciso dei giocatori del Liverpool all'altezza del centrocampo propone un'iniziativa. Thompson verso Dalglish, è trattenuto Kennedy da Bonoff, ma evidentemente non in modo tale da richiamare l'attenzione del signor Palotai. Sbaglia l'intervento ma rimedia Hannes. Dovrebbe attaccare il Borussia in questo momento, probabilmente lo vorrebbe, ma è impedito chiaramente dall'insistente manovra del Liverpool. Avete visto un intervento piuttosto duro di Bernie Fox ai danni di Highway. Fox, lo ricordiamo, è destinato sempre a marcare l'uomo più pericoloso dell'attacco avversario. Lo ricordiamo avversario di John Cruyff nel finale di Monaco in occasione della vittoria dei tedeschi sugli olandesi. Anche per lui gli anni passano, ma si tratta indubbiamente di un grosso talento calcistico. Questo traversone di McDermott in direzione di Case non è stato sfruttato. È quella che stiamo seguendo, una partita con protagonisti piuttosto illustri, tutta gente che ha vinto parecchio in tutta Europa. Bernie Fox è indubbiamente uno dei più anziani e si appresta a guidare la Germania federale in occasione dei campionati del mondo. Vedete Völlers, l'intervento di Thompson piuttosto deciso ai danni di Wittkamp che si è portato in avanti. Ecco Thompson, uno dei più giovani del Liverpool, sicuramente uno dei più efficienti. Ecco Nielsen, centravanti arretrato, come vi dicevo. E Neil, che ora manovra scambiando con McDermott, traversone in direzione di Kennedy che gioca prevalentemente all'attacco, direi costantemente all'attacco. Hughes verso Sones. Vedete che anche il gioco del Liverpool non è che sia particolarmente fantasioso, finisce sempre per arrivare in zona di tiro col traversone alto. Jimmy Case mantiene il controllo della palla, ma l'arbitro Palotai ha rilevato un intervento scorretto da parte di Nielsen, punizione per il Liverpool. Solito pallonetto a spiovere e ancora una volta Kennedy riesce a far meglio di Bonoff, senza peraltro riuscire a portare avanti la manovra. Questo è Enkens. Sones, vi abbiamo detto, è l'uomo nuovo del Liverpool. Ecco il tiro preciso di Dalglish, rete. 2-0 per il Liverpool. Avete visto ancora una volta la testa di Kennedy svettare più in alto nell'area tedesca e servire Dalglish, che con un perfetto a volo di sinistro ha infilato Cliff per la seconda volta. Rivedete l'azione. Probabilmente il portiere era anche coperto dal compagno Bonoff, ma indubbiamente è stato un tiro di grande precisione. Vedete Dalglish, autore del secondo gol per gli inglesi, 2-0 quindi per il Liverpool, e adesso la vita diventa veramente difficile per il Borussia. Avete visto un gesto di quasi di rassegnazione da parte del portiere Cliff, che invita i suoi ad andare in avanti con questo lungo rilancio. Non ci pare sinceramente che questa sera l'attacco del Borussia sia all'altezza della tradizione. Indubbiamente l'assenza di Alan Simonson si fa parecchio sentire. E vedete come il Liverpool invece sia in grado di sostare costantemente nella metà campo avversaria e di arrivare spesso davanti a Cliff. Per il Borussia questa sera ecco in azione Bonoff, tiro deviato e comunque controllato con facilità da Clemens, giocatore europeo per il 77. Evidentemente questo riconoscimento non ha portato fortuna né a Simonsen e tantomeno al Borussia. Borussia che peraltro è sempre al primo posto a pari punti con il Colonia nel campionato tedesco, mentre il Liverpool in campionato non riesce ad essere così irresistibile come in Coppa Campioni. In questo momento si trova al terzo posto nella classifica a ben 6 lunghezze dal Nottingham Forest, che guida il campionato inglese. Un'azione piuttosto confusa ed è McDermott che ha la palla per il 3-0, ma non riesce a sfruttarla dopo una clamorosa esitazione di Cliff, il portiere tedesco, per la verità ostacolato da Case nella situazione che potete osservare. Comunque McDermott aveva la palla per il terzo gol. Roy Clemens, portiere della nazionale inglese, alla battuta. Dalglish verso Highway, ma la palla è troppo lunga e si perde sul fondo. Il Liverpool ormai non rappresenta più il calcio locale, ma addirittura tutto il calcio inglese, soprattutto dopo che la nazionale bianca, i cosiddetti maestri, sono stati eliminati dal campionato mondiale. Nel frattempo, vedete, Il signor Palotai sancisce la fine del primo tempo, 2-0 per il Liverpool, marcatori Kennedy al settimo, Dalglish al 34esimo. Ed eccoci al secondo tempo, Liverpool sulla vostra sinistra, lo ricordiamo in maglia rossa. E subito all'attacco, secondo lo stile di questa squadra che, ripetiamo, non concede molto all'improvvisazione, ma si affida soprattutto al grande temperamento per risolvere ogni tipo di problemi. Vedete che Highway è sfuggito a Fox, traversone e rimedia Wittkamp in calcio d'angolo. È il primo minuto della ripresa, la situazione, ve lo ricordo, vede in vantaggio il Liverpool per 2-0 nei confronti del Borussia di Mönchengladbach. Calcio d'angolo, alla battuta è Highway. Situazione piuttosto difficile per i difensori tedeschi. Frattanto siamo in grado di comunicarvi gli altri risultati relativi alle partite di questo mercoledì internazionale. Erano in programma alcuni appuntamenti di rilievo. Per la Coppa UEFA si sono qualificati per la finale che si disputerà in due incontri. Ricordiamo che la Juventus, la detentrice della Coppa UEFA, si sono classificati, vi dicevo, il Bastia francese, che ricorderete ha eliminato il Torino, e il PSV Eindhoven olandese. Queste partite si disputeranno il 26 aprile e il 9 maggio. Per la Coppa delle Coppe, successo dell'Austria di Vienna nei confronti della Dinamo di Mosca per 5-4 dopo l'effettuazione dei calci di rigore. L'Austria di Vienna incontrerà nella finale di Parigi, in programma il 3 maggio prossimo, i belgi dell'Anderlecht. Il Belgio è la nazione che vanta pertanto due finaliste nelle coppe internazionali, particolare da sottolineare se si pensa che il Belgio non si è qualificato per i mondiali, essendo stato eliminato, come qualcuno di voi ricorderà, dall'Olanda. Altre nazioni rappresentate sono l'Austria, grazie all'Austria di Vienna, finalista nella Coppa delle Coppe, la Francia con la Bastia e l'Olanda con la Eindhoven. Probabilmente anche il Liverpool, visto come stanno andando le cose, ma è ora in azione Wimmer, il cui tiro è deviato in calcio d'angolo. È questa forse la prima autentica occasione per gli attaccanti tedeschi. Avete visto che Smith, a volta Bernie Fox ha ragione in modo corretto del diretto avversario Highway, ed ora scambiando con i compagni di linea cerca di organizzare la manovra con Hannes, Bonhoff fermato dal solito Kennedy. Intervento di Sonnes, un giocatore prezioso. Highway verso Dalglish, fermato, calciato alle spalle per la seconda volta, traversone di McDermott. Kennedy al tiro e parata sicura di Clef. Vedete però come le incursioni di Kennedy risultino insidiose e sempre in condizioni favorevoli di tiro, di colpire la porta avversaria sia di testa sia di piede. Tra l'altro il tiro di Kennedy è di potenza ragguardevole. Jimmy Cale servito da fallo laterale, intervento piuttosto deciso di Hannes. Questi è Wimmer. McDermott alla rimessa, scambia con Neil. lungo traversone, è scontata la manovra di Neil, è uno specialista di questi traversoni in aria, quindi Highway in lotta come sempre con Fox, gli riesce il traversone questa volta, Kennedy verso Case, abile il suo dribbling, tiro, rete! Terzo gol per il Liverpool, autore Jimmy Case, dopo una brillantissima manovra, un dribbling vincente e un tiro secco, imparabile per Cliff. Rivediamo l'azione del terzo gol inglese. Vedete ancora Kennedy protagonista nell'azione, sua l'idea di servire Case in questa circostanza, saltato letteralmente Völlers e poi a colpo sicuro Jimmy Case mette a segno la terza rete. Siamo ora alla mezz'ora della ripresa. Il Liverpool sta conducendo nei confronti del Borussia per 3-0. Avete visto poco fa la rete di Jimmy Case che, aggiunta a quelle segnate nel primo tempo da Kennedy e Dalglish, danno un bottino considerevole al Liverpool e ben poche speranze al Borussia. Azione condotta da Dalglish. Highway è fermato da un intervento piedi uniti di Fox. Nel frattempo vi segnaliamo che il responsabile tecnico del Borussia ha operato due sostituzioni. Sono entrati Schäfer e Linen al posto di Völlers e Wimmer. La situazione però non si è sensibilmente modificata, perché è sempre il Liverpool a controllare con autorità la situazione. E ora in azione Hannes. È sempre Bonhoff il più intraprendente dei tedeschi. È chiaro che a questo punto il Borussia dovrebbe segnare due volte per riportarsi in vantaggio e sperare così di arrivare alla finale di Wembley, impresa che, mancando poco più di 10 minuti al termine, ci sembra alquanto improbabile. D'altra parte ci sembra di poter dire che il vantaggio del Liverpool è stato largamente legittimato, perlomeno per quanto abbiamo visto fin qui, da una prestazione convincente, mentre il Borussia è venuto meno non tanto sul piano del gioco quanto sul piano dello spirito, della combattività. Non abbiamo riconosciuto negli uomini di questa sera la formazione, ripeto, quasi irresistibile degli anni scorsi. È festa grande indubbiamente per i tifosi del Liverpool, che dimenticano così le ultime amarezze peraltro procurate dal loro comportamento, che non rispecchia affatto il famoso fair play inglese. Voi sapete che i tifosi del Liverpool sono tra i più turbolenti del mondo, spesso protagonisti di episodi poco edificanti, per stare bassi. È notizia proprio di ieri che le ferrovie inglesi avrebbero deciso di non dare più la possibilità alle famose carovane rosse, così vengono chiamate le spedizioni dei tifosi del Liverpool, la possibilità di viaggiare sui treni inglesi, perché troppo spesso sono stati maltrattati dalla tifoseria del Liverpool. Va detto però che Liverpool, al di fuori del calcio, rappresenta una faccia dell'Inghilterra non proprio ufficiale, perlomeno quella più pittoresca, la più popolare, la meno conosciuta dalle agenzie turistiche, tanto per farci capire. qui è nata la musica pop, Liverpool ha dato i natali ai Beatles, tutte le manifestazioni così di una certa esuberanza nascono da queste parti e poi casomai vengono promosse a livello internazionale dai londinesi. Ma indubbiamente Liverpool è una città interessante e questa squadra rappresenta un po' il suo stemma più prezioso. È una gioia immensa per Liverpool poter essere in questo momento la prima della classe del calcio britannico. Questo malgrado, lo ricordo, si sia privata l'anno scorso di un elemento importante quale Kevin Keegan, che come già vi ho riferito è stato ceduto ai tedeschi dell'Amburgo. Azione ancora di Linen. In occasione, ritornando a parlarvi del tifo degli ammiratori del Liverpool, in occasione della partita di andata, ecco, vedete che Nielsen è stato liberato in zona gol ma in posizione di fuorigioco e pertanto questa marcatura non viene convalidata dal signor Palotai. Vi dicevo, i tifosi del Liverpool, tornando da Düsseldorf in occasione della trasferta della loro squadra proprio contro il Borussia, ecco, potete osservare come la posizione di Nielsen sia fuorigioco, Kennedy rispetto alla finale di Roma, non c'è assolutamente dubbio che il Liverpool, azione di Delay, libera McDermott in calcio d'angolo. Dicevo, rispetto alla partita di Londra, di Roma, non c'è dubbio che è stato il Liverpool a compiere dei progressi sensibili. Vedete questo affondo di Delay e l'intervento difensivo di McDermott. Roy Clemens richiama all'ordine in queste ultime battute i compagni della difesa. Parte il calcio d'angolo battuto da Schäfer ed è proprio Clemens che, come vi dicevamo all'inizio, era stato un po' messo sotto processo per quella famosa punizione di Bonhoff che l'aveva trapassato. Questa sera Clemens non ha, direi, avuto l'opportunità per ribadire la propria classe, perché in effetti è stato troppo poco impegnato nelle poche occasioni, comunque se l'è cavata da campione. Quindi a questo punto mi sembra di poter dire che la finale della Coppa dei Campioni sarà disputata, oltre che dal Bruges, anche dagli inglesi del Liverpool, e pertanto ecco una conclusione di Sonas che finisce alta, e pertanto due nazioni escluse dai mondiali in Argentina del Borussia. Bob Paisley, vedete, segnala, mancano 3 minuti alla fine. Bob Paisley è stato per tanti anni un assistente del famoso Bill Shankly, un allenatore addirittura da leggenda per il Liverpool, che un bel giorno si è stancato e ha deciso di andare in pensione. Quando i dirigenti della squadra del Liverpool si sono trovati nella circostanza di dover provvedere alla sua sostituzione, qualcuno fece il nome di Paisley, che era sempre stato prima di allora un personaggio piuttosto trascurato, un tipo timido, che improvvisamente però ha portato alla massima responsabilità, è riuscito a cavarsela alla grande. Infatti il Liverpool, come vi dicevo, da 2 stagioni è una delle migliori, se non la migliore, squadra europea di club. Bob Paisley, l'allenatore, 54 anni, è indubbiamente uno che in questa vicenda ha dei grossi meriti. Si canta e si beve sulle tribune dell'Anfield Road. Sarebbe interessante seguire questa sera la notte brava dei tifosi del Liverpool, ma potrebbe anche rappresentare una esperienza pericolosa, perché sapete, da queste parti ecco ancora Highway cerca la soddisfazione personale, la meriterebbe, ma la sua conclusione di sinistro finisce abbondantemente sul fondo. Highway, uno dei beniamini del pubblico del Liverpool, vedete come si è liberato bene, è un po' l'azione che ha dato il successo a Jimmy Case in occasione della terza segnatura. Non è riuscito il tentativo di Highway, che comunque rimane un personaggio da seguire nelle vicende del Liverpool e del calcio internazionale. Sentite il coro dei tifosi, è l'aspetto forse più pittoresco, più gradevole. Udo Lattek parlando di questa cornice ha detto nei giorni scorsi: l'inferno al confronto è roba da ridere. Mi sembra che abbia un po' esagerato, ma ha reso se non altro l'idea. È chiaro che questa sera all'inferno, purtroppo per lui, ci sono andati i giocatori del Borussia, anzi direi che sono andati proprio arrosto, perché quasi mai hanno dato la sensazione di poter replicare efficacemente alla sostanziale superiorità degli inglesi. Il tempo è scaduto ed infatti in questo istante l'arbitro Palotai decreta la fine della partita e quindi il successo del Liverpool nei confronti del Borussia per 3-0. Vi ricordo le marcature: al settimo del primo tempo Kennedy, al 34esimo Dalglish, al nono della ripresa Jimmy Case. Il Liverpool pertanto giocherà la finale della Coppa Campioni a Wembley il 10 maggio prossimo, affrontando i belgi del Bruges, questa sera vittoriosi sulla Juventus. Con queste immagini noi ci congediamo e auguriamo a tutti buonanotte.
We played really well against Borussia Mönchengladbach. I remember it was one of the few games where I played up front, and I remember giving Bertie Vogts a far bigger run around than Kevin ever had in the game the previous year, which he'd had such great, you know, credit for. But we really battered them.
Souness for Dalglish. That's a good ball. Kennedy is in the middle and there are others arriving. Kennedy! So that's levelled it up. Good ball from Souness. Dalglish collects, steadies, crosses, and Kennedy is waiting. Good power from the header and the goalkeeper stranded.
Borussia Mönchengladbach has some fantastic players. Some fantastic players. You know, Reina Bonhoff. There's some absolutely superb players. And they were all, that was the big star team then. And you knew what to expect. They were always well disciplined, well organised. But they had some fantastic talent in the team as well.
Dalglish, the shot, and it's going in! Borussia will do well to catch them now. It in, just the weight taken off it by Kennedy, and Dalglish's shot with the goalkeeper unsighted and late.
Anfield under lights in those days was fantastic. It had a special atmosphere, and the buzz and the glamour of European competition is always one that the lads sort of wanted to be a part of, and they always rose to eventually.
Hughes. Kennedy stealing in with an offside flag up against him. And a challenge there by Smith that is going to get him a yellow card.
78 I played all the way through until I moved into a new house and doing a little bit of gardening, and somebody left a pickaxe on the wall and it just dropped, broke me toe. So that was me finished at Liverpool completely, you know. We managed to win the European Cup, you know, and I was more than happy for the lads, you know. That was good.
Kennedy, a very clever little header for Highway.
away's cross towards Souness's head. Kennedy on his chest. And finding Case. And Case has got room for a left foot shot here.
We just enjoyed our football then. We enjoyed winning. And we never looked, if you want, beyond our station, beyond the sort of next round or whatever.
Bill Green and Alvin Martin are coming up. Here's Brooking. Hitting low this time, flicked over by Cross. He's having a lively start. Corner work so that Brooking could hit it in low. It was no more than a flick from Cross, but it was over the bar. Alvin Martin sticking well to his man, the little back heel there by Tommy Taylor. And another free kick to West Ham. A little chip, finding Trevor Brooking. Oh, and Clements down just before Robson could get to it. Quite the calculation that Trevor Brooking meant. He took that well and he calculated it and looked for Robson. Clements was there. Cross. Sanders picking up the loose one. Fairclough. Long cross there. Martin hiding that behind for the corner. It's a real test for this young man. Had some half a dozen so games, and to be pitched into this sort of crisis is a real test of his temperament. Oh, Phil Neal in a lot of space and punched away by Ferguson, but not for very far. Hughes now trying another one, and the space was there for Neal to exploit from that corner, and he really hammered that ball, and Ferguson got well behind it, punching it out, and Ferguson will feel better for that. West Ham throw. Looking, Bonds. Curvishly. Now Liverpool got plenty back. As Taylor lifts another one high in there towards Robson. Oh, and kicked off the line by Phil Thompson. That could hardly have been closer. And I can't quite think what Clements was about there, because as that high one came in, you would have thought it was certainly odds on him getting it, but Brian Robson must have got a touch. And Phil Thompson, who in the end had to kick it off the line. Thompson with a long high kick. Green coming for it. And Lampard coming for it. Dermot. Challenged by Brooking. Neal, crossed again towards Kennedy, and now it's with Robson. Oh, what a bad pass there, cut out by Evelyn Hughes. And Case let it go through, McDermott, that's a goal for Liverpool. Well, that's a shattering blow then for West Ham. Began when Brian Robson's pass didn't reach his man and Liverpool pounced on it, and the ball eventually came through to McDermott. All the goals away, Matt. 1-0. West. Cross. Thompson. Salas. Dalglish. And a beautiful ball played by Salas for Fairclough. That's a beautiful goal, that's number two, and now it's probably beyond recall for West Ham. What acceleration there by Fairclough. Souness put it through, and Fairclough always had the edge, and once he got it, bang. Goals still singing the West Ham song, the bubble song. Well, that would in pace, three against one. Only Bill Green is back, and here's Kenny Dalglish. Formality surely for number three. It is now. No, it's not. It is now. And still the game goes on. What an amazing incident. Dalglish was put through, and it looked a mere formality putting it past Bobby Ferguson, but he missed. He had a second go. The ball hit the crossbar. It came down to Jimmy Case. Everybody stopped, and still they couldn't put the ball away. And the whistle didn't go. Right, first of all, the Liverpool team then. Clements in goal, Neil, Alan Hansen in for Tommy Smith, Thompson, Kennedy, Hughes, Dalglish with 29 goals to his credit this season, Case, Fairclough, McDermott and Souness. And Bruges with something like 9 internationals in their team of various nationalities. Jensen, of course, who's a Dane, Bastijn's the captain, Krieger, who's an Austrian international, Lakens, Maas, the young 21-year-old, in fact, midfielder, Kools, a fellow we'll have to watch out for, Van der Aken, who has become really the boss of the side, De Kuba, Simon, Koo, who's a Hungarian, and Sorensen, a brilliant Dane, who they say, in fact, is the Clive Woods of Bruges. Well, if he plays as well as Clive Woods played here on Saturday, there might be a problem or two for Liverpool. The referee there is Charles Korver from Holland, who was here just a few weeks ago to referee the England-Brazil game, and is the only Dutch referee who'll be going to the World Cup in Argentina. The last seconds then before this 1978 European Cup final is underway. Bruges in the all-white strip will be attacking the goal to our left. Straight back to Berger Jensen. Well, Dalglish finally was able to make something of that. Back it goes again to Jensen. Jensen, who has a reputation of playing exceptionally well in European Cup games. This is the number 5, Gino Maas, the 21-year-old. Van der Aken, the real commander of the side. Well, brought down by Dalglish there, giving Bruges a free kick. Which Maas will take. Noticeable that the ball is in fact an official World Cup ball, slightly different markings than the one that we're used to seeing here, but that's the official World Cup ball. This is Koo playing it towards Sorensen, and you'll notice how quickly Phil Neal was on to Sorensen, this number 11 and danger man. It's with Phil Thompson and now with Ray Clements. Hughes, Thompson, Liverpool firm favourites, but then of course so were Arsenal on Saturday, and Ipswich know well enough what happened to them, and the Belgians came here saying, well, we were underdogs when we played Atletico Madrid and we beat them, and we were certainly underdogs when we played the fabulous Juventus side of Italy and we beat them as well. Thompson in very quickly for Liverpool. So although the odds must favour Liverpool, you must be a little bit wary of this Belgian side. Van der Aken, nice little ball played here to Simon. Simon past Thompson, but not getting it before it got to the byline. Goal kick to Liverpool. Liverpool, of course, with vast European experience. They played 96. This is their 96th European game, spread over 14 seasons. Long ball followed by Souness, and it's Lakens who hits it to Maas. Forward now to Koo, interesting character, he's a Hungarian who defected in fact 18 months ago. Oh, and he's given the ball away, he defected badly there so far as Bruges are concerned. Dalglish playing it in there, and it wasn't a very good ball played in, and easy for Jensen. Koo, the number 10 for Bruges, we should watch out for him, the Hungarian who defected 18 months ago and in fact played his first game for Bruges last Saturday when they were beaten in the semi-final of the Belgian Cup. Hughes, back to Ray Clements. Alan Hansen. Hughes to Saunas. Emlyn Hughes again. And now Terry McDermott attacking him as he likes to do from the middle of the field, but losing touch there. Basteins, Koo, and Lakin's linking up. Here's Van der Aken, the real danger man. Flicking it here for Gino Mas. Long ball forward there towards Simone, and Hansen's there. Back to Clements. Five minutes gone, no score. Saunas. Hansen. Playing in the centre of the back with Emlyn Hughes away on the left-hand side of the back four for Liverpool. Dalglish. Kennedy. Saunas again. Fairclough on the far side. Nodded in nicely. Dalglish diving in there. And Jensen was out quickly. Took a knock on his left arm, I think. As Dalglish went roaring in there. Ball played in there. Out went Jensen. You see it from behind the goal, that collision between Dalglish. Fairclough leaping beautifully there. And that's where the accident happened. The ball in play again now with Alan Hansen. And Phil Thompson. Hansen. Saunas gave it away. Here's Koo, the Hungarian. Nice looking ball there. Simonsen, or rather Sorensen's after it. Well, that was a bad throw out by Ray Clements, but in fact there was a handball as Van der Aken tried to control it. I think a lot of people expected Liverpool maybe to go a little harder at Bruges to intimidate them, I mean in the right sort of way. Well, but they've played it very patiently so far, Liverpool.
Well, this is a style, Brian. You know, they want to do this, and I think the quicker they get into this routine, the quicker they'll get on top of the game.
It's with Phil Thompson now. Dalglish being very closely watched indeed by Lakens and by Van der Aken there, and McDermott couldn't quite make anything of that one.
I think there was only one team wanted to win that game that night, and it was us. They had one or two suspensions, which were unfortunate for them, but then we got what we wanted, and that was a cup.
Phil Thompson's header, nicely guided there for Jimmy Case. 24 years old today. I know what a birthday present he'd like, and well, that pass to Fairclough was offside. Tommy Smith just admitting that he didn't even know it was his birthday, but I'm informed that it is. Jimmy Case, that is, the number eight. This is Jensen, the Bruges goalkeeper. Looked like a handball by Neil. It was an accidental one, it looked to me, but the referee, Charles Korb, has given a free kick to Bruges. Sorensen, the number 11, who was an amateur 8 months ago, just gone out of the picture. Mask going in, and a good piece of play by Phil Neal. Little slipping and sliding there, and Lakin's just a little hard there in on Fairclough. In fact, that number four for Bruges used to be known as Mac the Knife. He's known as the hard man in this Bruges side. Certainly he clattered into David Fairclough. Liverpool on the move again now with Neal. Case. Saunas. Ian.
Well, like, they're trying to play offside, the Belgians, and this is always a dangerous ploy with a player like David Fairclough, because he's so quick that I think he almost caught him once before over in the left wing, and if they try it too often, I think David could catch him.
I think they're renowned throughout Belgium for playing the offside game, so I think Liverpool won't be in the least surprised that that's what's happening in these opening minutes. Case cut out by Mas. This is Cools. We've not seen much of him so far. The marathon man, they call him, because he goes and he goes and he goes. He's 31 years old. And Thompson. Hughes played on for Kennedy. Cools has gone right there with Kennedy. Played back for Emlyn Hughes. Dalglish shielding it well again, as he does. And Kennedy couldn't quite find him the next time. Here's Cools again. A midfield man who strikes forward with venom, but that pass not reaching Sorensen. And here's Case again for Liverpool. Played down the line for Fairclough. Look at Lakin sticking right with him, though. But Fairclough turns it back in only for Van der Aken. And a fall for Neil. But now for Julian Cools. De Kuba outside him. Simon, here's De Kuba. Now Bastins, who scored early on against Juventus in the semi-final. De Kuba. Bastins trying to play it back in there again, and it's with Dalglish. Turn, a little bit of shielding, the accurate pass this time for Terry McDermott. Played on again, this time for Jimmy Cooks. And no trouble. That never to be forgotten night when Manchester United beat Benfica here, and 1971 when Ajax of Holland beat Panathinaikos of Greece. Kennedy for McDermott. Case away on his right, Fairclough up, and again they've caught him offside, but game allowed to go on. Neil, Sonis. Chipped in this time for Case. Can he get him behind them this time? He's got him behind Maas. Played across there, and so nearly. With Dalglish on the far side, it was the captain of number two, Bastines, who saved them there. A corner then for Liverpool, taken by Terry McDermott. McDermott, a deep cross again. Kennedy on the far side, allowed a lot of leeway there. Played in again this time for Graham Souness. A little chip in there. Well, that certainly looked like a foul on Alan Hansen. But it's a goal kick. Tommy Smith.
Well, Liverpool, you know, just about putting the pressure on now. Which probably the nerves of the first few minutes has smoothed the game out. But now that they are putting pressure on, I'm working around the offside. But I think Blues are going to struggle for the rewind until they get more composure. But put the balls in the box there and trouble them. And I think probably Liverpool are going to take note of this and for a few more.
So Cools for Bruges. And Hughes doing his job well. Sonis, McDermott. Bastines. And a lovely little ball played this time for the Hungarian coup. Simon is in there. Bastines is right in there. They'll have to watch that to number two for Bruges. Alphonse Bastens, their captain. He used to be an outside right. He loves to come forward and is a good crosser of a ball. And certainly knows when to come forward and attack. As he did against Juventus in the semi-final with a goal after only 3 minutes. 0-0 here. Sorensen with the corner for Bruges. Kennedy heading it away. Cools beaten by Dalglish. And the long ball forward hoping to find the pace of Fairclough. Bruges reclaiming handball there. Fairclough has gone past his man. Case is waiting in the middle, and he tried to make something of it. There was a bit of pushing and shoving going on there, but Case couldn't quite make it. Now can Kenny Dalglish, safely held by Jensen. Interesting break that, though, by Fairclough. Hughes. quickly, but it's noticeable that Haas reacted quickly with him, and here's McDermott getting in there, and that nearly came for Kennedy. It might still come for Kennedy. Oh, across the face of the goal. It looked a certain one. Well, there was a case there of the midfield man, as Ian St. John was said, getting forward. It's McDermott getting it through there, a missed kick, and Kennedy getting it back across the face of that goal and past the post. Sorensen. Oh, fight for possession there, and now it's Fairclough. Played on again for Case, but Mars is there. And Case a little strong on Mars, and I think Jimmy Case is going to get a yellow card. For the foul on Mars, and you can see a bit of Belgian anger there, those Bruges players, for the challenge there. Did it look as bad as all that to you, Ian St. John?
No, Jimmy Case went for the ball there, Brian. I think that's ridiculous. I mean, he had to go for it. He slid in, and, you know, the lad just fell over his leg. Nothing in it at all.
Change your opinion now. Case, that header now, Dalglish. Oh, the challenge was quick there. Kools, Simon, and Hughes in for Thompson. Back it goes to Clements. They're a real team of hustlers. When they see anything even slightly breaking their way up front, they really hustle for it to Bruges. That's a lovely ball, though, for David Fairclough for Liverpool. Played inside for McDermott. Case is right in there. On the far side, Kennedy is coming up, but Jensen with the throw out for De Kuba.
We played Bruges a couple of years earlier in the UEFA Cup final, first leg at Anfield, and they'd really proven to be a good side. But on this occasion at Wembley, they decided to play very much a flat back four style, and that made it very difficult for us. It frustrated everybody.
Thompson, Hughes. Fairclough, and clearly an obstruction there, yes, and given. I think not only an obstruction there by Bastines, who wasn't happy with the decision, but I think Kenny Dalglish got an elbow in the nose as well. So, free kick for Liverpool. Is running over it, that lazy left foot of Ray Kennedy. Hansen's up here, Neil is up there, a good header in, and Jensen had to jump for that one under pressure from Fairclough. Hansen's header there for Hughes, playing his 73rd European game. McDermott, now Dalglish, rippling little run, brought down. And a good advantage play, but he won't let that advantage go, as Van der Aken will get the yellow card this time for the foul on Jimmy Case. So the referee, who was reluctant to give yellow cards when England played Brazil, has now given two. One to Case and one to Van der Aken. Having trouble finding his pencil, I gather, but he's found it now. So, do we fancy Jimmy Case, I wonder, to send a blistering shot through this Bruges wall and into the back of the net? That's exactly what Liverpool could do with now. 2-4-5 in the wall, and there's Jimmy Case through the wall! Punched away! The power of the shot, you get some indication of that, because Jensen's punch virtually went away into touch. Tremendous, look at the ball soaring away there. Thompson, his feet dangerously high there, on Simon, giving Bruges the free kick. I think we've seen that Bruges are not a side to be trifled with. In their semi-final against Juventus, they went to Turin, a side packed with Italian World Cup players, and only conceded a goal from Bettiger right near the end, and then won the second leg 2-0. Van der Aken with that little chipped free kick. Kennedy getting it away, but not very far. Here's Kools. crossed in again there. Clements for this one, grabbing it well at full stretch. And a nice throw here to McDermott. And onside this time. Fairclough's okay, and Lakers is after him. Fairclough is up, Case is going in, off the goalkeeper. And it'll come this time for Dalglish. A chance though for Bruges to reform perhaps. Saunders with the shot just over. That was a brilliant break by Liverpool. And it was the hard work of David Fairclough in the first place that did it. But there was the finishing vic by Saunders. Case. Oh, what a lovely ball there. Now Fairclough, oh! Brilliant piece of goalkeeping and a brilliant ball in the first place that put Fairclough free. There's the ball from Terry McDermott, just beating the Bruges defender, and the keeper did well, and Fairclough went in. A free kick to Liverpool. Now Fairclough with it. I don't feel that Liverpool are in any danger at the moment. You'd feel a little more comfortable, and I'm sure millions of watching it would, if only they could put the ball in the back of the net. Hansen there, and he very nearly did. Punched away that time by Jensen. It's a free kick by McDermott, the big young defender up there again. The Danish goalkeeper playing for Bruges, tipping it away.
The game was nothing much of a spectacle. The Bruges manager really came to stifle us, really. There was only one team to try and win at Wembley. That was us, really. Of all the five finals I played in, I think that was the most monotonous to try and break down a stubborn 10-man defence.
Gently through for Graham Saunders. Leash picking up the ball and finding Neil well there. Case. McDermott. Saunders and an offside again. The mixture as before in that first half. What's the answer to that offside business, Ian?
Well, the answer is that somebody has got to come from the other end of the pitch. If Graham Saunders had turned it and played a diagonal ball, somebody coming like Kennedy from the other side of the field could have caught him.
A massive kick by Jensen, almost to the edge of that Liverpool penalty area. Here's Saunders again. Now for Kennedy. Fairclough. Steins is there. Oh, Fairclough shoved him off it, and he's allowed to get away with it. Played in there towards Kenny Dalglish. Oh, and turned away in the end by Maas, just as Jimmy Case came in. It's a corner for Liverpool. The ball in play again now. And McDermott crossing it in. The corner taken very quickly there. Dalglish on the far side. Beaten in the air, though, by Birger Jensen. Kools looks a very good player still, and now Sorensen, we've seen so little of him. Well, and we're not going to see much of him all the time. Hansen plays as well as that. Bastines with the throw. Koo going for that one, but Hughes got there first. It's Saunders, Kennedy. Oh, he was clobbered from behind there, blatantly by Lakens, but here's Dalglish. That little rippling run, and McDermott's all the way through. Is this number one for Liverpool? Saved by Jensen. Brilliant keeping. And a really breathtaking break there by Terry McDermott. The goalkeeper is down in pain in his own six-yard area. The game going on, no, it's pulled up with Koo injured. And they want to give the goalkeeper a bit of treatment. But what a moment that was. It's got the crowd buzzing here. Two Bruges players are down. It was a tremendous break. This Dalglish played his part there, and just look how McDermott pounced on it. And away he goes towards the edge of that area. The keeper coming out fast. He really lets fly. Tommy?
Yeah, you know, it's a it's a hard thing to say, but
you know, he probably should have scored, Terry, but, you know, to get the break that he did and go past the fella, you know, people think he's a bit slow, Terry, but he's not. He is quite fast. You know, but, you know, it's all right saying do this and do that, but, you know, maybe he could have got a bit closer, but I don't know, it's a good chance, and I don't think it's going to help Bruges' confidence any.
They're all 100% again. Maas, who was injured just after that save, and the goalkeeper himself are both fit again. And here's Dalglish looking much more sprightly in this second half. And look at McDermott thundering through the middle once more. It's with Kennedy. Getting past Dakuba. Now, an accurate left-foot cross is what we want, and Fairclough was jumping there so well, but beaten by Jensen.
Liverpool at the moment are starting to create chances, Brian. They've came out in the second half, they've stepped up a gear, and they must have created at least three chances now in the first 5 minutes or so.
Well, we'll watch for that as Neil, well, he hits the ball straight to Kuls. Van der Aken, long ball now for Sorensen. This could be very dangerous now if Sorensen's got the beating of Hughes, which he has. The player with all the tricks. But has he delayed it now a little too long? I think he has, and Clemens is out there, but I think it's a corner off Koo. The first real sight we've had of Jan Sorensen, the Dane, used to work for British Leyland, incidentally, in their finance department until about 8 months ago when he signed professional for Bruges. He had Hughes and Liverpool a little worried there. So the corner coming up now for Bruges to be taken by Koo. The Hungarian played wide towards Sorensen and Dakuba. Sorensen missing his kick. Hansen, a long ball there for Fairclough to chase. George Lakens is there, back to his keeper Jensen. Kuls stopped by Hughes. Well, that looked a fair challenge to me. Played the ball. So this is the second time I've seen this Dutch referee at Wembley in the last month, and he's a World Cup referee. I'm bound to say I've not been all that impressed with him on either occasion. It's now with Van der Aken, number 7. Well, quite a shot on him. Clements, in fact, playing his 64th European game, and he's had quite an easy night so far. Now it's Saunders as Liverpool break forward again. Neil linking up well on that far side. Ball played in, but straight to Coles, and they get it away again without any bother at all. Good play, though, by Thompson. Saunders again. And Jimmy Case onside this time. Played inside for Saunders. Will he let one fly? Well, a goal kick. 10 minutes of the second half gone. Only Simon's up, and there are three Liverpool players back. Thompson and Hughes for Neil. Dalglish beaten away by Basteins, but unfairly. Well, unfair challenge in the back on Kenny Dalglish by the skipper of Bruges, the number 2, Alphonse Basteins. And now Dalglish! Taken before Bruges were alive, and it nearly killed them. Very quickly taken, and while they were still looking, the ball planted wide.
It gave offside anyway, Brian. Kenny just went away just a shade too early.
And that's a foul by Hansen on Simon. Saunders, who has just taken that free kick, known as a midfielder who can mark very well. Well, Now, can Liverpool get away this time? It's Dalglish again. Only Fairclough is up, and he's got to turn and check and look around. Saunas. Again, they're defending well in numbers. They're not known as a good defensive side, but they've made very few slip-ups so far tonight of Bruges. Another alehouse ball there by Phil Thompson. Beautifully gathered, though, by Jensen. Nice touch there by Simon. And now Sorensen. Neil is after him. This Dane can move a bit. He's got past Phil Neil. Well, Hughes blocking that one. Simon, or rather Sanders, and now De Kuba. Sanders, this time Lakens. Defender coming forward. He was doubtful for a long time for this game with an ankle injury, but he's a trained physiotherapist himself and gave himself treatment to make sure that he could play. So, a familiar sight of Liverpool coming forward, but without quite that mean, incisive play that we've seen so often, and particularly in the last month or so in their game. But Van der Aken, De Kuba, and Bruges are battling well. 17 minutes of the second half gone, under half an hour of normal time to go, still 0-0. Thompson playing it back, and Highway is coming on. It's Jimmy Case who's going to come off. Kennedy. Dalglish. Claiming handball, not given. Ball out of play, the chance presumably for Steve Highway to come on. So while Emlyn Hughes waits to take the throw, Jimmy Case, who I thought had a sparkling first half, I haven't seen quite so much of him in the second half. Does it surprise you, Tommy Smith?
Well, probably the boss has decided that we've got so much of the game that we need another forward on to score goals rather than bring Davey off, who's always liable to get an odd goal or two. He's brought Stevie on with the idea probably to do a little bit more attacking and for somebody to put at the back of the net.
So four up now, most of the time for Liverpool, I'd imagine. Or maybe just three at the back, as Emlyn Hughes looks as though he's moved forward a little bit. But certainly the idea is to take the battle even more now to Bruges. Saunas' little pass onside, good decision there by referee and linesman, the little chip by Kenny Dalglish, and the magic side of that ball in the back of the Bruges net, and Liverpool in the lead.
No, just get through. That's only me and the goalkeeper. And he dived earlier, but two or three times before, Terry Mack had been through twice, and he hit two good shots, but the goalie had gone early. So when I went through, I thought, well, here's hoping.
Oh, magic, you know, it's terrific. You know, Kenny's, well, you know, like Ian was saying, he seemed to be taking the time, but now he's put that one in, and, you know, that was exactly what he should have done. You know, you couldn't have done any better. It's fabulous, you know, unbelievable.
Now it's Kennedy. 30th goal of the season for Kenny Dalglish. And what an important one there. And away goes David Fairclough, but Bastien's across. Well, that was a marvellous piece of substitution by Bob Paisley within 30 seconds of the substitution having been made. Liverpool go into the lead. And the Liverpool fans now with more than enough to say for themselves. A throw for Bruges, which Jan Sorensen will take. A deep one there. De Kuba's right in there. and it was an overhead tried by Van der Aken, and a throw for Liverpool. 24 minutes to go. Chant of Dalglish going up all around Wembley now. Speeding Dalglish, but what a battler he is. He won that ball for all that. Saunas was knocking pulls off the ball when they were both away from it. But allowed to go on again. Here he is, the number 11 for Liverpool. Crossed in nicely onto the far side, and it was Maas who put it behind for the corner with McDermott just behind him. Out by Souness. Now Highway. Played on again for McDermott, onside, and the header by Fairclough, only finding Kennedy. Dalglish. It'll come for Kennedy, hit in first time. Oh, a flying attempt there by Fairclough, but Coles now bringing it away for Bruges. Still 1-0 for Liverpool, 20 minutes to go. And now Fairclough, played in for Kennedy, the midfield men coming forward well. Now that's a good ball if Highway can get to it. Highway for Liverpool. Played again for Dalglish. Highway getting very quickly into this game. Nice little pass played here for Dalglish. Look at the space there that they've allowed him. And Sonoy's played it short for Sonnerton. This could be trouble now. Turn back again and knocked off the line by Phil Thompson.
You just sense danger. And I think with my nose, I sense it a bit more than others. And Alan didn't get his foot behind it enough, and it's gone between Clem and their striker. And the striker's gone, and with him coming across the pair of them and having to go between them, it took him slightly wide, which gave me the opportunity to get back on the goal line. And you know, your life flashes before you. Well, that's what it did in those couple of seconds when that ball was coming, and I just stretched out my left leg and just managed, it was about that far inside the post, and just got my foot to it and just turned it away, just knocked the ball away.
Simone so close to getting an equaliser, and that really would have been a terrible lapse of concentration by Liverpool. Alan Hansen's mistake in the first place. Clements almost put it right. Simone on the turn, and that man Phil Thompson there again.
Big Al, he was only a young lad, and he played in the European Cup final. He'd gone back to Scotland, chest out like that, loving it. Got his medal in his hand, and he was with all his friends and everything down the pub. Look at this and everything. Look at me medal, and they were going, "Oh, not about your medal. What about your dodgy back pass?" And they slaughtered him because of his back pass.
And with 11 minutes left, Liverpool have got it. Got to keep on the ball right to the end. That's a foul by Bastines on Fairclough. And a free kick to Liverpool. That's the foul. Free kick coming up. McDermott. Saunas. A little chip by Saunas. Kenny Dalglish is there. Kennedy is there. And whether that ball gathered a little bit of pace, it fooled the pair of them when they got in and behind that Bruges defence. A minute to go. Hughes. Oh, and Sanders and Hansen got in now, the long one away by Kenny Dalglish for David Fairclough to chase. I suppose you're delighted that you're so near the end and winning, but it's not been a really distinguished Liverpool performance, Tommy Smith.
Well, you know, the problem is playing against a team that don't want to play. You know, I think they were so scared. You know, after you think about it, I think they've been so scared it's not till Liverpool scored that they've come out, and it's as simple as that.
Well, you've seen how many offsides they've had since Liverpool scored, and this is why Liverpool are pushing up and they're trying to control the game more. What can you do when a team doesn't want to play?
I remember saying to the referee, yeah, how long to go in the 78 final. And him being Dutch, he sort of said, a minute. I thought, you know, this could go on all night. You know, I want to stay out here all night because it was just fantastic. We were in control at that time, even though it was only 1-0. But I would have, the 78 one was very, very special. I didn't want the final whistle to go, but when it did, and you're on the pitch, as I say, and you're part of a European Cup winning team, The feeling was just amazing, and it meant a little bit more to me than 77.
Well, they haven't got to play much longer. 15 seconds on my watch. A little bit of time to be added on for injuries. Not the time for the slightest Liverpool mistake now, holding this narrow 1-0 lead that would give them the European Cup again. Ray Clements getting it away. Tremendous achievement. And the second goal now to cap it off would be brilliant. There's McDermott with a shot, but it's way over the top.
I think Ian. Oh, he's happy to see that one go over the top because it looks as if it's all over now.
It's a fantastic achievement by a club side. Of course, back in the 1950s, Real Madrid won it 5 times on the trot. Ajax of Holland and Bayern Munich have won it 3 times on the trot. Liverpool now look poised to win it twice. I think Evan Hughes said after the final last year, well, what are you going to do now? All we can do is win it again, and that's what Liverpool have done! Champions of Europe, Liverpool for the second successive year, the first British club to win the European Cup, Europe's major trophy for 2 successive years. The goal by Kenny Dalglish in the second half is the one that separated the two sides. Graham Souness, who had a tremendous game in the midfield, and the number 7, Kenny Dalglish. And the Liverpool fans delighted. Scoreboard already running up. Congratulations, Liverpool. Winners 2 years running of the European Cup. And hard luck for Bruges. Ray Clements and Jimmy Case. What a beautiful picture of happiness. The 2 men up the front got through a lot of work. And it'll be Emlyn Hughes for the second successive year who goes to receive the sparkling European Cup from Dr. Artemio Franchi, the president of UEFA. Not the greatest European Cup final by a long way, but one where Liverpool kept battling and battling and battling and weren't discouraged, and in the end got their just reward. Bob Paisley on the field there, no wonder he's hugging Phil Thompson, who had a truly brilliant game at the back. And I wonder what Tommy Smith's immediate reaction briefly to that is. Tom, if only you could have been out there yourself.
Yeah, I'm choked, actually. Well, I'm made up for the boys, you know, it's absolutely... I'm nearly crying, actually. I don't know, it's unbelievable, really, to think Liverpool could win it 2 years on a trot. And there's only one team going to win it tonight, and it's Liverpool, of course, you know. It's, well, you know, I'm over the moon, as they all say, but I tell you, it's tremendous. Just unbelievable.
Well, the thought of Tommy Smith being near to tears will tell you just what it means to Liverpool. As Emlyn Hughes climbs those famous steps again, with Terry McDermott just behind him. Well, they let that glittering cup go for a few days. It'll be back on the Liverpool sideboard tomorrow morning. And look at that picture of delight. The broadest smile in football belongs to Emlyn Hughes and hordes of Liverpool fans and British football fans for what Liverpool have achieved for us tonight. Well done, Liverpool.
because I remember when Kenny Dalglish scored that goal, and everybody jumping up and down. When it actually stopped, you could feel Wembley vibrating, it was shaking. Because there's that many people there. Remember that?
There's only really a few things I can actually remember about the actual match. There was the goal by Kenny. There was a volley by Graham Souness. And the back pass by Alan Hansen that was cleared off the line by Tomo.
And Sonoy's played it short for Sonnerton. This could be trouble now. Turn back again and knocked off the line by Phil Thompson.
I don't think any of us realised what an achievement we'd sort of made in 78, being the first English team
to retain,
not only to do it twice, but to retain the cup. Yeah. And I think, you know, when you think that, you know, how many other teams have tried to do that. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, we'd lost supposedly our best player in 77 in Keegan,
yeah,
and we placed him with somebody even better than King Kenny.
Well done, Liverpool. The Liverpool chairman, John Smith there. Terry McDermott, Alan Hansen, who was in for our old chum, Tommy Smith, and a bit of a hold up getting down that stairway. The fans are engulfing it, trying to prize that cup away from Emlyn Hughes. Jimmy Case and David Fairclough, Kenny Dalglish, who got the winner, Phil Neal, who was brilliant at the back, Ray Kennedy, and I think to most people's minds the man of the match, who kicked the ball off the line when it looked as though they might get an equaliser, Phil Thompson.
We've had a fair amount of success, and I'd like to think that we've, you know, found a few friends with the football, and I think we've been a credit to the game.
That was probably the greatest period of Liverpool Football Club. You know, the 76, 77, 78 period of winning the League and UEFA Cup in 76, the League and European Cup in 77, and then the European Cup again in 78. To win them five trophies in less than 2 years. It was an absolutely super time.